が、あの、現在、雅楽の楽琵琶として伝えられております。
So it is said that the Biwa's ancestor is wood in Arabic country. And from current Arabic countries, Iran or Iraq, through Silk Road, and through China, it arrived in Japan in 7th or 8th century. And old style beer is called Gakubiwa, and it's kept its style, and now it's performed in Gaku music.
一方ですね、あの九州の方ではあの目の見えないお坊さんがお経を唱えるときにこの琵琶を携えて演奏したんですが、そのうちに鹿児島の島津藩は楽器を改良したり、また新しい曲を作って、武士の間に広めました。
And around the same time in Kyushu area, which is west part of Japan, blind monk used biwa when they pray and became as Moso Biwa or blind monk Biwa. And this blind monk Biwa or Moso Biwa came to Kagoshima and was modified for warriors and who used Biwa for new storytelling.
江戸時代になりますと、これがあの、まあ、武士の方から一般の人たちにもこう広がっていきまして、この薩摩琵琶の元になったと言われております。
In Edo era, in 16th, 17th century, Edo is current to Tokyo,And Satsuma had power in Japan at the same time, so the people in Satsuma brought that Satsuma Biwa to Tokyo, and it became a more popular instrument as Satsuma Biwa.
明治時代になりますと、あの、お三味線の音楽をこう取り入れまして、筑前琵琶といった種類の琵琶が発達いたしました。
In the Meiji era, which is about 19th century, and it got influence from shamisen, which is three-string banjo.And a new type of biwa called chikuzen biwa became popular.
現在ではね、あの、新しい奏法も開発されておりまして、世界にあの新たな作曲素材を提供し始めております。
So these days, current biwa is we have developed new method of playing, and we take elements from different music.And we are developing new type of viewer to the world.
それでは最後のプログラムになりました。平家物語より熱盛をお聴きいただきましょう。
So I'm going to play the last piece. It is called 熱盛 from Tale of 平家。
源平須磨の戦いで、落ちゆく平家の武者一騎を呼び止めました源氏方の熊谷次郎直実は、組み敷いてみますと、実は我が子と同じ年頃の花の金たちがありました。
In the war, in Genpei Suma war, and one warrior called Kumaga Ichiro Naozane took a warrior and he tried to kill him. And he took the helmet called Kabuto, but he found the warrior is very young, beautiful boy.Whose age is about the same as his son, and he felt very sympathetic, and he tried to rescue him, not killing him. However, his troop came just behind him, and he had to end his life. So that is a very sadness for this warrior.
そうですね。あの、兜を取って見てみますと、我が子と同じ年頃で、助けたいと思った熊谷次郎直実は、味方の軍勢が後ろにこう近づいてきておりまして、やむなく歌ねばならぬ無言の悲鳴を歌ったものです。それでは、田中当該作詞、鶴田錦氏作曲、平家物語より熱盛です。どうぞお聞きください。
Please listen to 熱盛。It was composed by 鶴田錦氏 and lyric by 田中当該。
Oh,
呼ばれて集まり戦方はなく敵に後ろ